So in this video, we're going to look at whether or not the Dyson headphones are actually good at cleaning out the air that we breathe. So I'm not going to go too much into whether or not they're good as headphones and how well the audio and the sound quality is in those. I'm sure other people, lots of other people have done reviews on those. What we're going to concentrate on here is just how well they clean the air. So first things first, these headphones retail in the US for around $1,000. That includes your headphone section and then also below this mask section. So you have a set of headphones and a mask which can clip on using magnets. Pretty neat, pretty nice, so that you can walk around, listen to your music and also hopefully breathe clean air. So these headphones do have Bluetooth, so they can link to your phone or whatever audio device you use. They also do have noise cancelling, which is really important. I'll come to that in a second. And then they have two fans and two HEPA filters inside the headphone. So that's the key. That's what we're going to be looking at here. I can open this up and show you all inside. Here is one of the HEPA filters on one side. Pretty easy. That just clips on there. And then the same on the other side. We have a HEPA filter on that side. So two HEPA filters. The air goes in here and then it gets filtered by the filter and it comes out into this mask section. So this mask section isn't actually filtering out any of the air. This is just blowing the air into the region around our face, around our nose, around our mouth, so that we can breathe clean air. So I've talked enough about the headphones and how the filtration works. Just how good are they at actually filtering out pollution in the air? So what we did at Smarter is we ran a whole series of tests where we tested just how much PM2.5, or in fact particles down to the smaller 0.3 microns, could be filtered out by these Dyson Zone headphones. And then we also compared it to simple N95 masks to see whether or not they were better or worse and what kind of use cases might you want to use these. What we did is we jumped into the Smart Air testing lab and we filled it with pollution. And then we tested the air outside of the mask and inside the mask. So this is a pretty common test. It's what's called a fit test. And essentially you're comparing the pollution outside with the pollution that you're breathing inside the mask. So all in all, what's the Dyson Zone headphone actually like? Well, they work really well at filtering out PM2.5. The H11, H12 filters in there can get 99.4 and 99.8% of particles in our test, which is really good. But having said that, that's just as good as an N95 mask that's fitted well. Another thing worth noting about the mask, if you're out and about, is that the headphones, when you're using the fan on high, will only last about 1 hour. So they'll only give you about 1 hour of battery life. If you're running it on low, you might get 3 hours, but still, that's not enough for a full day. So you'll probably want to bring a backup battery pack, or more likely, a backup N95 mask to wear when this runs out of battery. So I mentioned earlier that these headphones do have active noise cancellation, which is great. It blocks out noise from the road. But one thing that's worth noting is we tested these, and when they're run on high, even if you're listening to music, you can still hear the fan noise. If you think about it, you've got two fans right next to your head. When you put this on, you've got a fan here and you've got a fan here. So this is essentially right next to your ears, and it's going to be making quite a lot of noise and vibrations around this zone. They do have some very nice padded earphone sections here, but still, when running on high, you can actually hear that fan. So the noise cancellation can't get rid of all the noise. If that's not something you want, then probably not the best bet for you. One other final feature that these things have, which is quite interesting, is they have an NO2 sensor. So you can actually see, link this up with your phone and see the NO2 levels as you're running out and about. But again, how useful is that actually? Probably what we're more interested in looking at is PM2.5. This thing can't even filter out NO2, so I'm not quite sure what the thinking was there, why they put an NO2 sensor on there. NO2 sensor sounds cool, sounds funky, yes, but don't quite know what the use case for that is. Finally, it does come with quite a fancy travel case. I say fancy, it's pretty nifty, more than the price of a 3M mask itself. And you basically open and close it with this dial here. It's pretty big, it's pretty heavy, so it's not that convenient. But then on the downside, this thing is quite heavy. It weighs in at about 650 grams. That's 1.4 pounds. That's pretty heavy to be having on your head if you're running around. So yes, the filtration might be beneficial over a mask when you're going for a run, but no, you probably don't want to be wearing this when you're running anyway, because your neck might fall off, you might hurt your neck. On the other side of that, you know, if you are out and about wearing this, you do need to realize that the battery lasts 2 to 3 hours on high, slightly longer when it's run on low, but you're not going to get a full day's usage out of this. And at $1,000, it's the equivalent of more than 1,000 3M N95 masks. So it's very expensive for what it is, and it doesn't necessarily give you any more clean air. Would I use this? No, I would. Safe to say I'm not going to use this, and I'm going to stick to my N95 mask. It's small, it's lightweight, it doesn't run out of battery. I can use it whenever I want. I can tuck it away, put it in my pocket. It's getting 99% of those particles, and essentially it does everything that I need it to do, so I'm going to stick to using my N95. All right, guys, I hope that video was useful. I hope that was an interesting look at the Dyson headphone air purifier mask. And stay tuned and look forward to seeing you again. One final word, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and head over to our social media at Smart Air Filters to stay up to date. Ask us any questions. If you have any follow-up, please leave them in the comment below and we'll get back to you as soon as we can.